Hi y'all, good evening. It's Darla here with Growing Tropical. And yes, I said evening. I love to garden in the evening hours. I should have named my channel The Nocturnal Gardener. I love coming out here after dinner, and I love tinkering in the garden or sometimes just tearing everything up. It is the perfect time. It is so gorgeous out here right now. We've got the most beautiful, last couple of days, we've had the most beautiful Gulf breezes, and the humidity has been just significantly less, and it just makes coming out here and gardening just so incredibly wonderful. I love it. I wish every evening could be just like this. But you guys, I'm over here on the south side of a property, and I'm working on the window box. Now, this window box right here was actually absolutely gorgeous. It doesn't look too awful bad considering that it went from a full-on sun box to now full-on shade, which is why I'm having to actually change it all out. I think that everybody probably has these areas in their garden where from season to season, what I mean is like from winter to summer, actually, where they go through, you know, transitions when the sun is lower, you know, in the sky, as opposed to higher, you know, in the middle of the summer months. You know, some of the areas, you know, of your landscape will be in maybe a full on sun during maybe the winter month and a full on shade in the summer months, much like this window box is right here. So I'm going to pop up a picture and show you guys what this window box actually looked like. And I want to say it was either the end of September or beginning of October when I planted this window box up. And of course, at that time, it was getting a full on sun. And so I planted things like the Blackie sweet potatoes. I've got one on either end. I have some spring of rye fern that's in here. I think this is also known as like an asparagus fern. Now, the asparagus fern can actually, in my experience, it can actually transition from sun to shade quite easily with absolutely no significant, you know, problems with it or whatever. And so this is going to be one that I'm going to probably just go ahead and leave in there because I love the texture of the asparagus fern. I've got one sitting right here, and I'm going to bring this up to the camera a little bit closer, but I just love the texture. I love the way it feels. It does, as it matures or whatever, it does get a little prickly, like prickery, but all in all, I love the texture, and it just works so well with pretty much any type of plant that you want to put with it as far as a companion plant's concerned. So I'm going to probably be leaving those spring of rye fern. But then the other things that I had in here was I had some creeping Jenny. Now I found also in my experience that the creeping Jenny, it can take a part sun, but it needs to have, you know, some sun of some kind. Last year, I believe I tried to leave a little bit of the creeping Jenny in the box when I was transitioning it, and it didn't work. It got to the point where it just didn't, it was too easy to overwater. And even though creeping Jenny does like to be watered quite a bit, it just didn't seem to do really well for me anyway. So I ended up taking it out. And so I'm going to be removing this creeping Jenny. It still looks pretty good. So I'm going to relocate it to probably another one, like a container somewhere around on the property. I'll find some place for it. And then of course, the other thing that's in here are the vinca or the periwinkle. Now these are definitely a sun loving annual, or we can treat them perennial here, because when you put these guys in, I can whack them back and they'll, you know, they almost like naturalize in here in South Florida. I don't know how they are in other states, but here in South Florida, they can definitely naturalize because they just keep seeding themselves. And if you put one in, by the next year, you're going to have 12. I mean, seriously, they really do grow. Matter of fact, I think when I was a little girl, if I'm not mistaken, my mother used to classify them almost as like a weed, kind of like a purslane, because they just grew kind of like weeds or whatever. But they certainly are very, very pretty with their pretty little blooms all over them. But again, that is a sun-loving, most people I think classify them as annuals, but it is a sun-loving perennial that I'm going to end up having to take out, and I'll relocate it somewhere else again in the landscape. So all in all, and then there was just, I'm sorry you guys, I forgot to mention, I had put some bulbs in here, some caladium bulbs. I'm going to bring the camera actually in a little bit closer so you can see. What I had done here was, bear with me one second while I bring this camera in. This particular caladium, if you can see right here, he already started coming up, and I think I'm going to go ahead and leave him because I love caladiums, and of course they are shade loving. So all in all, that box right there, the two Blackie Ipomoea sweet potato on either end, those are going to come out. the springerite fern, I'm going to go ahead and leave those. I'm going to take out the creeping Jenny, and I'm going to take out the periwinkle, and we're going to go ahead and start fresh. And this is what I'm going to start fresh with. I have here that springerite fern that I showed you guys. I'm not real sure if I'm going to be able to nestle him in, but I've thought about nestling him in. I have some beautiful shade-loving coleus. I've got these beautiful bronzy-leaved, and then I've got these beautiful chartreuse green, all shade-loving coleus. And then I've got these caladiums. Now these guys, again, they're shade loving, but look at the color that's in here. The beautiful deep green veining. And then there are splashes of like a really pretty red that's in there. I thought that was so, so pretty. And then one of my favorites, instead of the creeping Jenny that I've got over there that's going to end up coming out, I'm going to replace it with this pothos. I had this in the landscape under this beautiful Adonidia palm. I had it down all along the base over here, and I thought, you know what, I don't want that. I don't really think I want it there. I think it might be getting a little too much sun, you know, as we were going into the summer months. So I just went ahead and lifted it out. They were all just obviously, you know, they were still in their nursery cans like this. But I just kind of lifted them out, and it's really funny. You can kind of see the mulch. Can you guys see that mulch that's still hanging on there for when I pulled it off? It started rooting itself in the ground, but I thought it would look really, really pretty all perched over the side of that window box. And so that is the plan, to go ahead and transition the window box from sun-loving annuals and perennials to shade-loving. So I'm going to go ahead and get these guys planted up really super quick, and then we're going to come back and we'll take a look at them and see just how pretty they're going to look. Okay, I'll be right back. Okay, so it got dark on me like really, really quick. That's what usually ends up happening. It's like really super light and then it's really super dark. But you guys, I have to apologize because the whole time that I was planting, I thought the camera was on and apparently my battery must have died. So you won't be able to see me planting them up, and I do apologize for that. But I do want to show you what the end result looks like. I'm going to go ahead and attempt showing you this here later in the evening. Or well, actually it's dark time, but I do have some floodlights that are on either end of the house that I was able to put on, and I'm hoping you'll be able to see this. You can see it over my shoulder, but I'm going to show it to you a little bit up a little bit closer, and just how pretty this little shade box actually looks. So let's go ahead and go in a little bit closer. And as we go in here, I want to just show you guys remind you guys that I did go ahead and keep the two asparagus ferns. I had them on either end of the box. And really the only, those are the only two things that I actually kept in the box. I added these beautiful coleus. They're the dark margin, green margin coleus with the really tiny little, let's see if I can get my camera to focus, with the really tiny little splashes of red in there, which will be perfect because what I did in front of this, I went ahead and, whoops, let me see if I can't get this to focus, right down in front of this coleus, right down in front of this caladium, what I did was I planted a big bulb down here, and this one is a red color. So as that grows up and gets larger, it's going to contrast really nicely with that pretty little splash of red that's in there, and it'll grow up as just as tall as this one. And of course, going down along the back, I have the coleus. And then I've got two of the chartreuse with the deeper red inside, or like a burgundy color, I guess you'd say. Those are going to get very, very large. I have the chartreuse color in the back here. And then of course, on the other side here is again, the coleus with the red splashes in it. But y'all, these guys are gonna get probably about 18 inches tall back there, which is why I put them in the back of the box, because as they get taller, they will fill out so nicely. I mean, they're going to get, they're going to get, really, really wide, and they're going to get nice and tall. I've had these shade coleus in here before, and they get really, really nice. But once again, I repeated with the caladium down here, and I put another red bulb here in the front. So as that grows up, it'll, coordinate really, really pretty with this. And the only other things that I did was I went ahead and I put down inside here, I nestled in some more caladium bulbs, the red color, and I did it again over here on this side. And then I ended with these pothos all along the front here. I love pothos, and they just do so well in these window boxes when you have a shady condition, and they hang over just so, so pretty. So there you go. I know it looks like it might be a little bit bland right now, but for the most part, when those caladiums all start growing in and they start showing their pretty little red heads, and those coleus back here start really putting on some growth, and their little red, their little burgundy and red, splashes will start sticking out as well. This window box will become really, really colorful and really pretty. So there is the window box. I'm going to flip the camera around again. So I hope you guys were able to see that. Like I said, it just got so dark on me so, so quick, which happens very rapidly, but I love it. I love gardening in the evening time. It is so cool out here. As a matter of fact, when I end this video, I'm gonna go find myself something else to do, because there's always stuff to do in the garden. And I just really, really, I revel when the evening temperatures are like this. It's absolutely gorgeous. So you guys, I hope that you enjoyed this video. It was just a little something, something to show you how I transition out my pots going from the winter months to the summer months. In this case, this was a window container right behind me over my shoulder. And I hope you enjoyed it, and we will plan on seeing you guys in the next video. Bye for now.